Hi, I'm Harold Thimbleby, and I'm talking to you today from Wales. It's a lovely place, and I hope you can come and visit us here in Wales and go for walks when the pandemic's over. But today, I'm talking about demanding digital safety in healthcare. It's something really important. It's a passion of mine, and I want to explain to you why it's a really important problem, why it's pervasive and everywhere, and why we can do something about it and make digital healthcare safe. But first, I'm going to start off by acknowledging, of course, digital is amazing. Here's a doctor looking at some patient data in a hospital. That's something you couldn't do so easily without a computer. And yet, there are problems. Digital has many safety problems. This doctor is photographing all that patient data with his iPhone. He may send that photograph to the wrong person. He may have forgotten to photograph the patient's name in the photograph, and then they're going to end up with lots of photographs and have no idea who they're referring to. There are all sorts of problems with digital, and there's interoperability problems, password problems, slow computers, all sorts of things. Digital is amazing, but digital has got safety and health problems as well. And of course, it's got cybersecurity problems. You'll be familiar with the death at the Dusseldorf Hospital. Cybersecurity problems are an inevitable consequence of digital problems. We've lost the capacity to be shocked by all this. We just think this is how it is. But it doesn't have to be like this. And I'm going to take you through some problems to explain why we can fix it. Denise Mellinson died in 2006. She had cancer, and unfortunately, she had a fatal overdose of a drug due to a calculation error. What happened was that the pharmacist gave the nurses a drug bag with all these numbers on, and the nurses had to do a calculation. Originally, the calculation they did was using a calculator, but I'm going to show you the calculation using Excel because that's much easier to talk about, and you can see all the numbers and what happened. This is what happened. So I've set up the numbers that you need. That's a problem in itself, the concentration, the dose, and the duration. And we're going to work out the rate for the drug infusion. And we're going to put in the number of hours and the calculations. And this is the correct calculation that is required. But we've made a mistake. We've got 28.8 mils per hour. This is exactly the mistake the nurses made because we're trying to get milliliters per hour, but we've done a calculation in days. So let's change days to hours. Well, first we can change the word, but then 4 days is 96 hours. We'll put that in. And we've now got 115 milliliters per hour. This is even bigger, and it is still wrong. What's gone wrong this time? Well, I made a typing mistake. I didn't actually type 96, but it looks like 96. There's a character in there you can't see. We need to correct that, and when we correct it, we'll get the right dose at last. What have we learned? We've learned that Excel is unsafe, and I think it's a worse problem. It doesn't tell you when things go wrong. So you believe you're getting the right answer, but you're not getting the right answer. I'm going to take you through a bigger part of the story in the hospital. First of all, pharmacists drew up the drug bag and stuck the label on it. They gave it to some nurses. The nurses, there were two nurses, they did a joint calculation to check their calculation, and sadly, they both made the same mistake. Then one of the nurses went to the infusion pump with the drug bag, put the new drug bag in, and pressed buttons on the infusion pump and gave Denise Mellinson an overdose. Let's have a closer look at that infusion pump. The nurse is highly trained. She presses buttons, and the infusion pump didn't say, "I've been giving this patient 1.2 mils per hour over the last few months. Now you're increasing it by a factor of 24. Are you sure?" The programmer made a decision not to check the number with the nurse. So what have we learned? Infusion pumps are unsafe, and they don't tell you when things go wrong. But it's interesting to look at the training behind all of this. The pharmacist requires a degree and takes about 4 years to qualify. The nurse, two nurses, they both require degrees and they take about 3 years to qualify. But the programs, the infusion pump, or Excel for that matter, need programmers. And the programmers decide what actually happens in the story. The programmers can get their jobs with no training and no years to qualify. This is why I'm worried about unsafe digital healthcare, because we're not thinking clearly about it. We're not demanding quality digital. Everybody is excited by digital. This is a typical photograph of exciting digital stuff. And it reminds me when we were excited by cars. Here's a classic car showroom, 1950s cars. And in the 50s, people were excited by cars that could go faster. And people were not worrying about safety. Here's a photograph of an accident the famous actor James Dean had in 1955 with one of those classic cars. The car collapsed and he died. In the 50s, we had lost the capacity to be shocked. We just thought, this is what cars are like. Buy a new car. So the analogy is, digital healthcare is really just sales from excited, and we end up with car crashes. In 2014, my son Isaac borrowed my car and he had a car crash at about 100 kilometres an hour, the same speed I believe James Dean was driving at. He hit another car and everybody walked away from the cars uninjured. What's happened since the 1950s is car safety has improved enormously. Cars have got airbags, seatbelts, crumple zones, ABS brakes and the rest of it. The errors still happen, but the technology has improved to make cars safer. This change in culture happened because Ralph Nader wrote a book called Unsafe at Any Speed. He exposed the horrendous problems that were happening in cars, and he showed that they were engineering problems. Everybody at the time said, drivers have accidents, that's why we have accidents. He said, no. You have accidents because the cars are unsafe. We can fix the cars. And it's now a lot later, but we have improved car safety enormously and everybody benefits from it. We need to be shocked at the car crash that is healthcare IT, and then we can start doing something about it. We've all got to start demanding safer IT rather than exciting IT. I need to show you that this is possible. So let's go back to the Excel, the problems that we had before. I typed in something that had got an error in it, and Excel happily gave me a fatal dose as an answer. But Excel could have used all sorts of things it's already got. It could say, is it valid? No, it's not valid. It could put up a diagnostic. It could say there's a bad character, or it could put up a diagnostic that interrupts you like this. These are three ways that Excel already does for handling errors. But to put it bluntly, it can't be bothered to tell you about errors that could kill people. It could do. Or we could try completely new methods like this one that is a bit more specific about how the error can be corrected. And if you correct it, you end up with the right answer. We use Excel in hospitals. Here's an Excel spreadsheet for radiotherapy calculations. It's got 20,000 cells and 1,000 hidden formulae. The chances that this Excel spreadsheet for radiation therapy is right is zero, in my opinion. Why are we even using unsafe spreadsheets? Well, I think it's because of showroom thinking. We go to buy the stuff that's available in the showroom, and that's all we can buy. Excel is the only spreadsheet on offer. You get what's on offer, not what's safe. So, do you want showroom excitement and car crashes? Or do you want safer cars? You can't buy safer cars if the showroom's only got exciting cars in it and no safe cars. That's exactly the analogy we've got with healthcare. Here's my picture of exciting digital healthcare, and here's a picture of a patient in bed that needs safe healthcare. What have we learned? We've learned that digital could easily help us detect, avoid, block, manage, and recover from errors and improve safety and improve health if we demand it. So we can fix IT and make it much better. And to do that, we need some powerful messages, I hope like this talk is, and like a book like Unsafe at Any Speed is, that brought everybody's attention to the problems and said, we can fix them. I've written a book called Fix IT, Fix It, How to Solve the Problems of Digital Healthcare. It's coming out in July. I hope you'll enjoy reading it, but its message is the details behind the talk I've just given you. And if we zoom in to that picture and the person on the front cover, this is just a typical hospital. It's full of digital stuff. We need this digital stuff to work well and safely. It might take time, but we will get there if we demand digital safety now.